one can of Rotel tomatoes with chilies. We've got some frozen chicken breasts. Just dump those right in. Just flatten that out on the bottom. Add your seasoning. That is taco seasoning. This is the quickest and easiest dinner that your family will love. Dump some corn on there. This is drained a little bit. Now we're gonna add some black beans. This is actually really healthy. It's super fast. You just dump everything in there. You've got protein, you've got fiber. You got another can of tomatoes with chilies. And that goes right on top as well. And I do like mine spicy, so we're gonna add some jalapenos as well. Just dump those jalapenos on there. Oh my gosh, this is gonna be good. And then we top that off with a little bit more of our, and we top that off with a little bit more of our taco seasoning. A healthy dose right on top. Now, this is delicious and healthy and probably the easiest meal you'll ever make. That's it. You just dump everything in. You turn it on high. We're gonna cook this for 4 hours on high, or you can do 6 to 8 on low. And then you're gonna see some beautiful shredded Mexican chicken. Dump your chicken in. This is about 2 or 3 cups of pre-cooked pulled chicken. And then you're gonna dump in your vegetables. We've got corn and peas and carrots. Now on top of our veggies, we're gonna add some cream of chicken soup. We've got 2 cans, these are the 10 ounce cans. Now we're gonna take one of those cans and we're gonna fill it with some chicken broth. And we're gonna add that liquid to our mixture here. You could use milk if you prefer, that's another option, but I've just opted for the chicken broth. Now we're gonna add some spices. First seasoning is gonna be some poultry seasoning. Now this has thyme, sage, marjoram, am I saying that right? Rosemary, black pepper, and nutmeg. So this is made for poultry specifically. Now we're gonna add some onion powder. And I think it goes on everything, garlic powder, right? Kyle, you love the garlic, don't you?
I do love the garlic.
Was that enough? We're gonna add some black pepper. Even though that poultry seasoning did have some black pepper, I think we can also hit it with a little bit more. And you know what? Don't kill me for this, y'all, but we're also gonna add one other ingredient, cheese.
Okay.
There's gonna be some cheese in this.
Cheese, that's in the fridge. I can get the cheese out right here, just in time for cheese. All right, here we go.
Now, this is optional. Let me know in the comments if you think cheese should go in chicken pot pie. We're gonna add just a little bit, not too much. And then we're gonna take our spatula and we're gonna just stir that up. Get in the bottom there. See all this goodness? We've got our chicken, we've got our veggies, we've got the condensed soup. And listen, y'all, I know that this is not homemade from scratch. We are fully aware of that.
But we're at home.
Well, actually, that's a very good point. Uh-huh. I am making this at home, so technically it's homemade, right?
Uh-huh.
But it is a quick and easy version with
You said version.
You never let me get by with this, did you? Let's try that again. It'd be better for you not to do that. Ready?
Uh-huh.
Now, this is a quick and easy version. I know we got a lot of busy. Damn it, let's try it again. Okay, ready?
Bye, rolling still.
Now, this is a quick and easy version. I know we got a lot of busy families out there watching us, and y'all have been requesting quick and easy, so that is what we're gonna give you. But if you want to make this from scratch and make it homemade, feel free. You can get fresh chicken, pick the veggies from your garden, get the chickens from the hen house, and how do you get cream of chicken soup from chickens? I don't know, but do it from scratch if you want to. And that leads me also to the next step. Like I said, quick and easy version. So we are gonna use frozen biscuits. This is the easiest chicken pot pie you will ever make. You don't even need to let them thaw. You're just gonna take those biscuits and cover the top. Yep, trust me on this, y'all. This is gonna be good. Take your frozen biscuits and cover the top. You don't even need to let them thaw. Let's say you just get home and you're in a big hurry. Well, this is how you're gonna get dinner on the table and the whole family's gonna love it. And these are the frozen kind. And as I said, make it from scratch if you prefer, but this is an option for you. The last biscuit goes right there on top. And that's it. You've got this easy dinner that the whole family will love. Everybody loves chicken pot pie, and this is the easiest version you'll ever make. whole box of dry pasta. We're using whole wheat because it's better for you. And then we're also gonna add some chicken. And this is already cold chicken. What's great about this chicken is that it's already cooked, so you're actually just heating it up. This is so you have a quick and easy version. Now we're gonna add 2 jars of Alfredo sauce. Pour that right on top. Beautiful. And we're gonna make this one healthy. We've got our whole wheat pasta, and now we're gonna add some broccoli. I've chosen the baby broccoli because it's even easier to cook. There we go. Now we're gonna add 3 cups of mozzarella.
That's a lot of mozzarella.
You gotta have the mozzarella. There we go. We are almost full, but we've got a couple more ingredients. Garlic, you gotta have some garlic. We're gonna get a tablespoon of garlic. Now you're gonna add 1 cup of chicken broth. And this liquid is what allows our pasta to cook in the pot. That's why you do not boil the pasta first. You've got your 2 jars of sauce and your chicken broth, and it will cook right inside here. 1 pot, less pans to clean up. Now, of course, you need some pepper. We're just gonna cover this top with pepper. Is that enough pepper?
That's perfect.
Now, there's one other thing we need. It's in the fridge.
Oh.
Parmesan.
I can get that. It's my job to get the cheese out of the fridge. All right, there we go.
Parmesan. You have other jobs too.
Yes, there we go.
We're gonna get 1/4 cup of Parmesan. Now, I wanna remind you guys, you can customize this recipe however suits your liking. If you wanna do everything fresh, if you wanna have fresh chicken.
Did you just give up on the Parmesan?
Yes, I kinda did. It wouldn't come out. There we go. Fresh chicken, fresh broccoli from your garden, milk the cow and get the cheese. It is up to you. But right now I'm showing you a quick and easy version, and it doesn't get any quicker or easier than this.
But is this healthy?
Yes, actually, this is a healthier version. We've used whole wheat pasta, which is high in fiber and high protein. We've used a lighter version of the cheese. You could even get light Alfredo sauce. They make that as well. And it's gonna be a nice filling meal. Now you have to stir it all up. Use your spatula and just give it a stir.
That is a lot of food in there.
I know, it's definitely full. But you just wanna just take it, make sure you get underneath there with the pasta, and just mix it up.
I'm very excited to see how this
turns out. Do you think this is gonna be good?
I have no idea.
So, we have made oven-baked pasta before, but we have yet to do it in the crock pot. So this is gonna be an interesting test to see how it turns out. And that's it, super easy. All you have to do is set this on low for 2.5 to 3 hours, and dinner is ready.
Wow.
So this has been cooking for about 3 hours. We've got 1 more hour left, but I'm gonna go ahead and we're gonna shred the chicken now. You just take your knife and your fork and just kind of...
Right in the crock pot like
that? Yeah, right in there, just shred it a little bit. It smells good, doesn't it?
Yeah, I can't
and
wait.
Then we're gonna put the lid back on and let that continue to cook for the last hour. And then we're gonna have a delicious dinner.
And I can't even peek yet, right?
Not yet.
All right,
our slow cooker Mexican chicken is ready. And this is one of my favorite meals because it truly is healthy. It's just grilled chicken, beans, black beans, which are full of fiber, corn, tomatoes. And you can use fresh ingredients, you can use canned, whatever's best for you is how you can do it. And another great thing about this is that you can serve this in many different ways. On tortillas as tacos, on chips as nachos, you could put this over brown rice, then you have a really filling meal. Let's check it out.
It smells delicious.
Look at it. Isn't that great? So what we've got here is this beautiful shredded chicken with our black beans.
Yep.
Look at that. Chilies, corn, and I've decided I'm gonna have this as tacos. And we're just gonna fill our tortilla just like that. And time for the taste test.
Smells so good.
This is my favorite. Just the right amount of spice. Your family's gonna love this.
I love this one. I have had this before. It's delicious, people.
Y'all, I am so excited for you to see how good the chicken pot pie turned out. I'll be honest with you, this is the first time I've ever made it in the crock pot. We've made it in individual servings in the muffin cups, we've made it in the oven, in a casserole, we've made it in a microwave, in the waffle iron, and now in the crock pot, and it is so good. Now, here are the baking instructions for this. Everything I showed you before goes in, and then you put the lid on and you bake it for 1 to 1.5 hours on high. But then you take the ceramic part out, just the black part. See, this lifts out. Take that, put it in your oven, bake it for about 15, 20 minutes tops at 375. And that is gonna give you nice brown biscuits. I can't wait for y'all to see them.
Wait. First off, chicken joke.
Kyle's got jokes.
Yes, why do chicken coops have two doors?
I don't know, why do chicken coops have two doors?
Because if it had four doors, it'd be a sedan. Oh, come on.
It was good. That means I like it. But
all right.
Boom.
All right, here we go.
Take a look at how good this turned out. Look at those biscuits.
Boom.
So, like I said, the ceramic part goes into the oven. Don't put the metal part in there, because if you burn up your crock pot, don't blame me. You only want to put the ceramic part. But this gave us a nice biscuit topping that's golden. And they all kind of melded together in that first hour and a half in here. So I think it's time to do a taste test.
Taste test time. All right.
Kyle's gonna come join me on camera for us to do the taste test together.
All right, here we go. Taste test time. Here I am. All right. Let's see. This is exciting.
Okay. Look at this, y'all.
All right, here we go.
Look at this. Look at how beautiful that looks.
Uh-huh.
Look at those biscuits. Perfectly cooked.
Look at those biscuits.
Why do you make everything sound dirty? How do you even do it? What kind of skill is that? Look at that. That is a delicious, perfectly cooked chicken pot pie, and it's time to taste it.
We shall see.
Man, those biscuits look good. Got our chicken, got our veggies. Sometimes. Kyle's really.
Feed me like a baby chicken.
Sorry, y'all. We've been cooking a lot today. We're about to lose our minds.
It was my piece. Oh my god. Give me that.
I'm sorry. I didn't know you. Don't get it on my head. Was that not delicious or what? This was the best chicken pot pie I've ever made.
That's good.
The secret is putting it in the oven for the last 15 or 20 minutes to brown those biscuits on top.
Brown those biscuits.
You did it again. Okay, so our crock pot chicken Alfredo is ready. And I'm very curious myself. This is the first time I've ever made this pasta dish in the crock pot. I've baked it in the oven before, and it always turns out great. But we'll see.
All right.
Okay, so looks like normal chicken Alfredo. Obviously, this needs to be stirred up a little bit. Wow. Look at that. And during the middle of the cooking process, I stopped to stir it a couple times. So this is definitely a cheesy pasta. The recipe called for 3 cups of mozzarella, but I think you probably could get away with only 1 cup because this almost looks like a mac and cheese, but we're gonna taste test it.
All right.
So we've got our broccoli in there, so that's added some vitamins and some fiber. We've got whole wheat pasta. We've got chicken, Alfredo sauce. All right, look at that. Let's see if it's cooked. Yes, the pasta is cooked. Now,
the pasta cooked in the crock pot, huh?
Yep, and this is whole wheat pasta, so it stays a little bit more firm than regular pasta. Get some of the chicken. Okay, here we go. A lot of cheese. It's perfect.
Is it good?
It's better than I thought it would be, to be honest. I didn't know what to expect. The pasta is soft. It is fully cooked. Our broccoli is yummy. You want to try it? You gotta try it. Kyle always opts for the red sauce, but you're gonna have to taste this one. It's a lot of cheese. Here you go. Give it a taste. What do we think?
It's actually good.
It's not bad, right?
It's not bad.
Okay, so
you
need a quick and easy meal. Dump it in there. Throw all your ingredients in. Set it and forget it. And you're gonna have a dinner that everybody's gonna love. Kids are gonna love this. Everybody's gonna love it.
Even Jax.
He's licking his lips.